Good evening, Stevens Point. I'm Nathan Wallin.
And I'm Breana Schmidt.
This week on SPTV News, Bell Soft Serve has officially opened for the season. The Badger men's basketball team finished off their regular season schedule, and the world celebrates International Women's Day.
All of this and more when we return.
Chicago, also known as the Windy City, reported accidents due to high winds this week. CNN's Julian Cruz has more.
We've got a company on the scene that they're going to get up there from the inside. They're going to remove the remaining glass and board that window up.
The Chicago Fire Department rushing to secure what's left of a shattered window. 38 stories up at the corner of Randolph and Dearborn. High winds almost certainly the cause of this early afternoon mishap, firefighters say. The falling glass hitting this passing car, blowing out the back window. Luckily, no one killed or injured. High wind gusts channeling between downtown buildings at near hurricane force. Crossing the river on Michigan Avenue is an adventure.
What was it like?
Scary, you know, with that water below you. Not really a fan of that, so.
Could you actually kind of feel the bridge kind of vibrating a little bit?
Mildly. Yeah, you can mildly feel it going, wobbling back and forth a little bit. She wanted to hurry up and get past the bridge.
63-mile-per-hour wind gusts blamed for down power lines in northwest Indiana, bringing traffic to a screeching halt on the Indiana toll road, for a time even delaying the South Shore train line.
The trees come down with the wind. I don't know what's happened. They did a lot of damage, and they cut all the power for inside my house.
Homeowners in Des Plaines giving thanks this afternoon. Nobody hurt as a large tree comes crashing down on the 600 block of Deborah, busting a fence and knocking out power.
The disruption of high winds in Chicago has been seen in roads, homes, and skyscrapers. Chicago will be seeing some clouds and possibly some snow next week.
This week, an investigation took place over the stolen CIA hacking tools that were given to WikiLeaks. CNN's Barbara Starr has more information on this criminal investigation.
The new investigation is an acknowledgement the documents appear to be largely authentic, detailing how the CIA hacks into common devices like phones, televisions, and computers overseas. The Trump administration won't publicly confirm the leak, but appears to have known about it for some time. The White House says this time it's a serious breach. The FBI and CIA will investigate for potential criminal activity and who might have been behind it. Officials would not say if they believe an employee, a contractor, or a foreign government was involved. WikiLeaks claims former U.S. government hackers or contractors leaked the material to them. Officials say documents detail hacking programs that have been used, as well as some being developed to collect intelligence overseas. One allegation, the CIA can hack into smart TVs, placing televisions into a fake off mode that can listen to conversations and relay those conversations back to U.S. spies, according to WikiLeaks. WikiLeaks also suggests the CIA was even studying technology that would allow them to take control of a car by hacking into its systems. The document mentions products made by Apple, Google, Microsoft, and Samsung may have been hacked. It's no secret operating systems have shown vulnerabilities, and manufacturers regularly offer fixes. The most notable hacking in a terrorism case came when the FBI paid a private company more than $1 million to hack into the phone of San Bernardino terrorist Saeed Farouk.
The government is continuing the investigation around the leak of information.
A new international relations certificate program is now being offered through UWSP's Political Science Department. This program is designed to teach students about the international government system, international security, international political economy, international organizations and laws, and foreign policy. Students must take 3 required classes as well as 9 credits of specific electives. The department hopes that students in this program will develop research and analytical skills as well as a broader understanding of political, legal, and constitutional constraints and opportunities that governments face when they engage in international relations.
The Survivor's Voice is accepting submissions for its fourth annual booklet. SPTV's Sarah Sartell, Eric and Jones, and I took a look at the inspiration behind the book.
Promoting Awareness Victim Empowerment, or PAVE, is an organization on campus that lets students talk about their violent experiences in a safe environment.
The Survivor's Voice is a booklet that survivors on campus in UWSP or in the community of Stevens Point share based on their experiences from sexual assault, interpersonal violence, and more recently we're trying to focus it on discriminatory violence as well.
The poems included in the booklet will feature a wide variety of violent experiences from student submissions on campus.
Sometimes it'll be just from what the survivor experienced, or maybe something that's heartfelt, but it's pretty much anything to kind of give them a voice.
Copies of The Survivor's Voice will be available to students when the organization is done publishing the booklet.
They can email us at pave@uwsp.edu. Otherwise, you can come and stop in the Gender and Sexuality Resource Center, room 206, and we have copies.
Students who have experienced violent events will get the opportunity to express themselves with others who have had similar experiences.
Mainly to give survivors and anyone that's experienced violence a voice is our goal, and to inspire others.
The Survivor's Voice has started to cover a wider variety of violence over the years to inspire more victims to share their story. This is Breana Schmidt, Sarah Sartell, and Erica Jones with SPTV News.
You have until March 15th to submit your story, and for more information, contact PAVE.
The Women's Resource Center is looking for new members to help serve UWSP students and the surrounding community. The Women's Resource Center has been raising awareness, ending stereotypes about sex and gender issues, and promoting diversity and inclusivity since 1977. They provide contraceptives, pregnancy tests, hygienic products, and educational materials to students, staff, and community members. The Resource Center is looking for volunteers who have a passion for social justice and educating others. If you are interested in volunteering or would like to learn more, please visit their office in the DUC.
Have you ever been interested in 3D printing? Well, the Albertson Hall recently had their event showcasing their 3D printer and teaching students how to use it. Austin Lepak has more.
UW Stevens Point has always strived to make technology available for everyone. The newest of these is the school's 3D printer, which is why they coordinated this seminar. The presenter, Matt Sonnenberg, readily agrees.
I think it's definitely important. I mean, I look at it like how if you go back to the early 90s, late 80s, early 90s, computers weren't like a big everywhere type thing. People had to go to libraries or a common place to go and get oriented with those, and you know, that grew into it being a technology that's everywhere and it's just kind of ubiquitous now. Whether or not 3D printing is going to take off in that same direction, I don't know, but I think it's very important that we offer it at least. Get students, you know, introduced to this technology, so if it's something that they see in the future, they are familiar with it and they can actually have some experience with it.
Even if you aren't planning on ever needing this skill, Matt Sonnenberg will tell you that it is important to try new technologies.
I mean, it's, I would say probably just because you don't know where things are going to go in the future, and having that experience and learning to be comfortable with new technologies is only going to help you. I can't think of any way that it's going to be a detriment to you to go and have that experience and learn from it, especially with 3D printing.
For SPTV News, this has been Austin Lepak reporting.
To learn more about how you can get your own item printed, visit the library's webpage.
Every spring, UWSB hosts an event for talented and creative sixth graders to visit campus and attend special classes taught by campus faculty. The school is looking for student volunteers who can escort the sixth graders to classes, answer questions, and help these kids have a positive experience. Student volunteers will be given a free t-shirt, lunch at DeBow, and earn observation hours and gain volunteer experience for their resumes. Volunteer sign-up is due March 15th, and the event will take place on April 7th, April 21st, and April 28th.
A popular ice cream shop in Stevens Point opened on March 3rd. Nicole Seiter and Nate Wallin have more.
An unofficial Stevens Point landmark, Belt Soft Serve, recently opened for their 36th season.
1981 Belt Soft Serve was originated. Prior to being an ice cream store, my grandparents tried a barley brew business, I think started in 77, 78. and it was in 81 they opened up this side of the building as an ice cream window, still operated the other side as a barley brew, but very shortly thereafter went to two windows of soft serve business.
Despite the freezing March temperatures, local residents camped out in tents outside the ice cream shop to ensure they were the first to get their cone.
You know, I saw kids coming here as kids, and now I see them coming back bringing their kids, and it's just, I don't know, the world comes full circle, so it's a neat thing.
Ice cream cones in all sizes, a variety of cold treats, and when in season, homegrown fruits.
Homemade ingredients, peanut butter cups, cookie dough brownies, and then alternatives, we do have some slush products and other things like that, but the main brunt of it's going to be soft serve treats.
A local institution, Belts is home of the large cone.
They were doing something fun before they came here and are just looking for something to extend that fun day, and fortunately we get to be a big part of that. So, you know, that's part of our connectivity, I think, with the community too. I like to joke that, you know, Belts is the cherry on top of a great day.
Just a short walk from UWSP campus, Belts Soft Serve is a popular spot on a warm summer night. For SPTV News, I'm Nicole Seiter.
If you haven't had the chance to visit Belts yet, they are open 11 a.m. to 10 p.m., 7 days a week.
Model UN is looking for 6 students to join them in the 2018 West Coast Model UN Conference. UWSB's chapter of Model UN was founded in 2016 and has already attended their first conference. To prepare for this conference, students will work to develop their writing skills, public speaking, develop and edit their research, negotiation skills, and gaining a better understanding of international relations. At the conference, each student represents a country who is a member of the European Union and takes that country's position on a set of issues as either the foreign minister or the head of government. Applications are due by April 15th and spots are limited.
Tickets for the 47th annual International Dinner are on sale now. This dinner is a special event that celebrates diversity and prompts the education of different cultures. The event includes traditional performances from other countries and includes dishes from Spain, Korea, Puerto Rico, South America, and more. This year's theme is Destinations Off the Beaten Track and will take place on April 8th, 5 p.m. in the DOC Laird Room. Tickets are $12 for students and children and $18 for adults and can be bought online or at the information and ticket desk at the DOC.
That's all the news we have for you this evening.
We will be right back with sports after the break.
Serving a campus of 9,600 strong, we are the home of UWSP Television. We are SPTV. You can find us on Charter Channel 983, online, or on any of our social media sites.
Don't let the snow and cold get you down this winter. The frozen tundra outside may keep you indoors, but here at SPTV, we'll still be getting you the best news, sports coverage, and entertainment that you need. Don't freeze your fingers and toes off to find out what's happening around campus. Stay warm, everyone.
Are you interested in pursuing a career in animals or just looking for a way to help preserve wildlife? Then the Wildlife Society might be just for you. As one of the largest organizations at UWSP, you will have your chance to help in projects that study and preserve animals, network with professionals, and meet like-minded people. Join us Tuesdays at 5 p.m. and join the Wildlife Society today.
And now, Ben Zutini with your SPTV Sports.
Welcome back, Pointers. In sports this week, the UWSP men's hockey team are your WIAC Conference champions after beating UW-Eau Claire in the championship game this past Saturday 3-2. Ethan Strong got the scoring started for the Pointers 5 minutes into the second period. Also scoring for the Pointers were Tanner Carty and Lawrence Cornelia. It was announced on Monday that the Pointers will play host to Aging University in an NCAA quarterfinal game on March 18th at 7 p.m. at KB Willett Arena. The Pointers and Bulldogs finished their season series 1-1-1. The Pointers beat the Bulldogs December 10th at Willett Arena by a score of 4-3. The Wisconsin Badgers finish off their regular season schedule, losing two of their last three games. They lost to Michigan State on February 26th, 84-76, and lost to Iowa last Thursday, 59-57. They then beat Minnesota this past Sunday on Senior Day, 66-49 at the Kohl Center. Bronson Koenig led the Badgers with 17 points, and Ethan Happ pulled down 13 rebounds. The Badgers will either play Iowa or Indiana in the quarterfinals of the Big Ten tournament in Washington, D.C. tomorrow night. It was also announced this week that the Badgers will take part in the Hall of Fame Classic this November 20th and 21st in Kansas City, Missouri. The Badgers will be joined in the tournament by Baylor, Creighton, and UCLA. Yesterday morning, it was announced that former Badgers head coach Bo Ryan will be inducted into the College Basketball Hall of Fame. Coach Ryan, alongside Jay Williams, Tim Duncan, John Stockton, Scott May, Cleo Hill, Rick Mount, and Paul Silas, will be inducted on November 19th. The World Baseball Classic started this past Monday. Israel finished pool play 3-0 with a 15-7 victory over Chinese Taipei, a 2-1 victory over Korea, and a 4-2 victory over the Netherlands. Team USA starts pool play against Colombia on Friday in Marlins Park down in Miami. They also play Dominican Republic on Saturday and Canada on Sunday. This past Sunday, Brad Keselowski won the Folds of Honor Quick Trip 500 at Atlanta Motor Speedway after Kevin Harvick, who led 292 of the 325 laps, gave away the win due to a speeding penalty on the last pit stop of the race. Harvick was one of the 13 speeding instances on pit road during the race. Despite finishing ninth, Harvick is a new points leader as the Monster Energy NASCAR Cup Series heads to their next stop, Las Vegas Motor Speedway. Keselowski looks to get back-to-back victories with a win in the Cobalt 400 on Sunday. The race starts at 3 p.m. That's all the sports stories we have for you tonight. Up next is entertainment news with Sarah Sartell. I'm Ben Zitouni for SPTV Sports.
Warzala, the seventh largest book printer in North America, is hiring students for the semester. We are 100% employee owned and located right here in Stevens Point, Wisconsin. All shifts currently hiring, with jobs starting at $10.80 an hour. Hours are flexible. For more information, contact the Warzala HR department.
How can you get involved with student media at UWSP? Connecting with your campus television station, SPTV, is easy. Like us on Facebook, subscribe to our YouTube channel, follow us on Vine, follow us on Twitter, follow us on Pinterest, follow us on Instagram, or connect with us on Google+. But of course, the best way for you to get involved and stay up to date with all that is happening at our station is to stop by our studio. We're located in the Communication Arts Center at UWSP, Studio B, Room 121. You can also drop by our office, Room 130, for more information on station happenings. We can't wait to get you involved. Come join us at SPTV. Let's make media together.
Don't have a television? Don't worry. SPTV is available on demand at uwsp.edu/sptv. Find your favorite shows on our website, plus links to all of our YouTube content. Stay up to date with SPTV news that includes information about campus and community happenings. And don't forget to like us on Facebook, we're SPTV-UWSP Television. SPTV, let's make media together.
Stand by camera one. Coming in on camera in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Take camera one.
SPTV News serves Stevens Point, the largest city in Portage County and home to 26,000 people. SPTV News covers campus, local, and national news, as well as local sports and entertainment. Melissa Mitrovic will present you the latest in Point news. Tune in to Charter Channel 983 or visit our YouTube channel. SPTV News, pointing to you.
Well,
Welcome back, Pointers. This week in entertainment news, Chance the Rapper has written a check for $1 million to Chicago Public Schools. Chance grew up in a suburb of South Chicago and recognizes the complications that Chicago public schools face due to lack of funds. The rapper urges the governor to invest more money into education, which will benefit Chicago's children. The check comes after Governor Bruce Rauner proposed a $215 million budget to give back to the schools. The funds from the check will come from ticket sales from Chance's upcoming tour and will be donated directly to the CPS fundraising arm. There will also be a series of $10,000 donations made to individual schools. Chance's social media power has brought much needed attention to the lack of funds that Chicago schools are facing, including how to gather the $215 million that Governor Rauner has proposed. The act of kindness sheds a light on the recurring issues of cutting funds that many schools and universities, including Stevens Point, are facing. Do some singing exercise and prepare your vocal cords because the animated movie Sing is coming to the DUC Theater. The future follows koala Buster Moon as he tries to save his beloved performing theater from being shut down. He promotes a singing competition in the town with a prize of $100,000. Animals from all walks of life gather to compete and become the next superstar. The cast includes some of its own superstars such as Scarlett Johansson, Taron Egerton, Seth MacFarlane, and Reese Witherspoon. The movie will be playing on Thursday, March 9th and Saturday, March 11th at 7 and 9 p.m. Admission is free with student ID or $3 without. Faculty and staff of Gender and Sexuality Alliance have organized a film festival on campus. SPTV's Ji Sung Kim has more.
This past Wednesday evening, the 2017 LGBTQ+ Film Festival began with the movie Kiki. Screening was co-sponsored by Sensetainment. The faculty and the staff of GSA talk about the purpose of the event.
Our goal with the Out on Screen Film Festival is to present an array of films, both documentaries and feature films, that show the diversity of LGBTQ lives. Films that cover economic diversity, racial diversity, ethnic and cultural diversity.
The faculty and staff explains the reason they have chosen Kiki as their first screening.
So we chose Kiki, tonight's movie, because we really felt that we wanted to start the festival with a bang. And this is a really good documentary about a very creative, very energetic, very gifted group of young people who come together, make a community for themselves in this underground ball scene, despite the hardships that many of them face. And so I think it was really important, when we sometimes only hear the negative experiences that transgendered youth have, that we get to also see their strength and their artistry and their creativity.
The audience expects some different perspectives from the films.
I expect something totally different. Maybe it'll be kind of like a finding yourself kind of thing, and to understand what it's like to be gay or lesbian or even transgender.
Moreover, the viewers are looking forward to this year's film choices.
From like the preview posters or the promo posters is that they're different ethnicities, so probably LGBT from different countries and how they're treated. Because I know around the world, like, there's definitely not everything's equal.
Lastly, the GSA faculty hopes the audience to enjoy their time watching the films.
We think we've chosen a lineup of 8 different films that are interesting as stories in of themselves. Even if someone doesn't identify on the LGBTQ+ spectrum, they've probably got friends or family or other acquaintances who do. So this is a way for them to maybe learn more about the lives of those friends and family. But also, they're good movies. We try to choose movies that tell good stories, that are engaging, and that really are interesting.
For SPTV, I'm Ji Sung Kim.
There will be more film showings throughout the month. The dates for specific films are listed in the UWSP calendar. Entertainment Productions is partnering with UWSP's own TIFU Cultural Ensemble to highlight African culture with a night of dancing, poetry, and musical acts. TIFU is a spoken word and dance ensemble that aims to promote African American arts and culture here on campus. Throughout the night, a variety of musical and artistic acts will be put on. This event will be held in the DUC Encore Room at 8 p.m. on Saturday, March 11th. The event is free with a student ID or $5 without one. That's all we have for you this week for entertainment news. Now over to Austin Lepak with Pointer Politics. I'm Sarah Sartell with SPTV Entertainment News.
Thanks, Sarah. This week in politics, Republicans are changing the way America views healthcare. Obamacare is being dismantled in favor of a new healthcare plan. The president is meeting with conservative groups to create a final healthcare plan that will eliminate the one that former President Barack Obama put into effect. The Trump administration is searching for a way to make influential changes, and this is one of the first big issues they are undertaking. Trump will begin to travel the country in order to talk to groups to create a strong healthcare act that will exceed Obamacare. If the act does not pass, Trump warns of a potential bloodbath concerning the 2018 elections. The controversial issue of healthcare will continue to be debated over the coming weeks. Wednesday, March 8th was International Women's Day. The goal of this day is to bring to attention the extraordinary achievements that women have made, as well as to acknowledge the struggles that many women face in their attempts to gain equality. In addition to the day, the organization Women's March on Washington created an event called A Day Without Women, which encouraged women to wear red in solidarity, not to engage in paid or unpaid work, and to avoid spending money. Companies such as Avon, PepsiCo, Ogilvy, and Caterpillar showed their support for the cause, as well as a host of celebrities. Facebook and Snapchat created filters for the day, and a rally was held in New York City. School districts in Virginia and Maryland were closed for the day as well. Even President Trump took to Twitter to express his appreciation for women. The organization Women's March on Washington has called attention to women's inequality and has many more events planned for the year. The 2017 presidential election sparked controversy over qualifications of candidates, political issues, and a debate over what the real facts are. This Saturday, Trump tweeted that he believed Barack Obama and had wiretapped Trump's phones during the course of the election. The president went on a Twitter rant, comparing the situation to that of Watergate. Kevin Lewis, a spokesperson for former President Obama, issued a statement saying that Obama nor any White House official has ever ordered surveillance on an ordinary U.S. citizen. Former National Security Advisor Ben Rhodes shared the same sentiment, saying that no president can order a wiretap. Despite the evidence, Trump is convinced that he was under a wiretap. Trump has not released any concrete evidence supporting his suspicions. The Environmental Protection Agency is facing budget cuts this week that could impact some of their most crucial programs. The announcement came amidst President Trump's budget proposal for an increase of over $50 billion towards defense spending. Non-defense budgets could be facing a loss, such as the EPA budget. The proposal calls for a reduction in the EPA budget of 24% and a possible 20% staff reduction. Programs that could potentially be lost include the Environmental Justice Program, Global Change Research, and the Clean Power Plan. Other programs include those in place to improve the quality of water and air. The environment isn't the only area facing problems. A decrease in EPA spending also impacts jobs across the country. While nothing has been finalized yet, these programs remain in danger of being cut until the presidential administration receives their budget approval. That is all we have for you this week in Pointer Politics. I'm Austin Lepak. We'll be right back after the commercial break.
Be a part of something super Greek at UWSP. There are 9 chapters and colonies on campus. Phi Sigma Phi, Gamma Phi Delta, Theta Xi, Sigma Delta Rho, Sigma Tau Gamma, Delta Phi Epsilon, Tau Kappa Epsilon, Phi Mu Alpha Sinfonia, and Phi Omega. Greek life at UWSP is a great way to build your personal support system and resume. With Greek life at UWSP, you won't just be a member, but a happy friend to the chapters and colonies for life. See what opportunities Greek life could offer you.
Great opportunity to promote leadership, a great way to get connections, and also to build bonds between different groups.
You get the opportunity to grow yourself as a leader and as a person, both through your organization and connections through Inner Greek Council and other avenues like that.
Greek life isn't what you see in the movies. I recommend checking out one of the recruitment events for the organizations and just seeing maybe you belong there.
That's all we have for you this week in SPTV.
We will not be having news next week due to the upcoming break. News will be back in 2 weeks. Until then, make sure to keep yourself updated on SPTV's social media pages.
Until next time, Stevens Point. Have a great night.